Lian Lee's 360mm Galahad 2 LCD AiO shattered our gaming tests, obliterated our CPU load tests, landed in a surprising place in our retail value charts, and comparatively, the GA2 LCD won't break the bank. What's up, guys, and welcome to another CPU cooler review here at Robeytech. We're checking out the 360mm Galahad 2 LCD AiO from Lian Lee, and you know what? If you couldn't tell from our intro, this CPU cooler was seriously impressive. From stellar CPU cooling under CPU and gaming loads, to the easy installation, all the way to that beautiful 2.88 inch 480 by 480 IPS display, there is a lot that we loved about the GA2 LCD. But like any product, it does come with its own set of consideration. Let's start with pricing and where it lands in comparison to other AIOs like it. At the time of writing this review, the GA2 LCD was available in both black and white with either a 280mm or 360mm radiator. The 280mm version cost $229.99 and the 360mm version cost $249.99, and these AIOs had Lian Lee's performance ARGB fans pre-installed. But those models seem to have vanished. It looks like the only model available are the ones with Lian Lee's SL Infinity fans, no surprise. I mean, by far their most popular fans, which you can get the 360mm version of one of these for around $279.99. But how does the GA2 stack up against other LCD AIOs? Well, you know what? The boxes have flat sides, so... Yep, nope, those stack up pretty well, you know, pretty... Oh, that's not what you meant. Okay, well, we'll just put that out of the way. Now, since there aren't a lot of options for 280mm AIOs with LCDs, we're gonna stick with comparing the GA2 LCD with other 360mm LCD-equipped AIOs, which also happen to be some of the models we'll be testing this against later. At the time of this video, the 360mm NZXT Kraken Elite retailed for $269.99, the ASUS Ryujin 3 for $349.99, and Corsair's H150i Elite LCD XT for $299.99. So the GA2 LCD isn't really a budget CPU cooler when you consider other 360mm AIOs like the Deepcool LS720 and LT720 at $139.99 and $129.99 respectively, or the Arctic Freezer 2, that's $149.99. However, when you compare it to other LCD equipped models, which is not those, the GA2 LCD does all right for itself. Even when you throw in the version with Lian Lee's SL Infinity fans, that's the one that lands right in the range with these other popular LCD AIOs. Now, the one outlier, which is an older one now, and I don't even know if they make this anymore, is the EVGA CLC-X, which also happens to have a 280mm version. The 360mm version of that retails for $179.99. We have shown it before, and if you're interested in a review, we might look at that if it's even around anymore. Now, when it comes to building with the GA2 LCD, Lian Lee makes this super easy. If you're building an Intel-based system, the GA2 LCD supports the modern LGA 1700 socket for 12th and 13th, and you also have support for LGA 1200, which is your 10th and 11th gen, and LGA 115X. So pretty much any core series desktop processor Intel has put out in the past, yeah, maybe decade. Sorry, Core 2 Duo enthusiasts, this AIO won't work for you, and that feels a little bit of an overkill. On the AMD side, the GA2 LCD supports Ryzen CPUs on both AM4 and AM5. So you got your 3000, your 5000, and your 7000 series all covered. But here's something that we absolutely love. Because this is an 8th gen ASATIC AIO, they have drastically improved the installation experience for AMD users. Rather than using the bracket clips AMD motherboards ship with, the GA2 LCD has those replacement extensions that match the holes on the motherboard. Basically, what this does is when you add 4 screws and the bracket swap, now the AMD motherboard bracket matches the hardware on the pump head. So in other words, it's like an Intel at that point in time. So you don't need to swap out hardware on the AIO pump, and no more wondering how many Intel or AMD brackets you're gonna have laying around like we do when your builds are essentially done. It's basically one bracket for all, woohoo! And did I mention that the GA2 LCD comes with its fans pre-installed on the radiator? So basically, with pre-installed fans and easy to use mounting brackets, this is the AIO I need to bring with me on those like PC speed building competitions. My record all the way getting it all done with an AIO and everything was 15 minutes, by the way, while also eating a hot chip challenge. but I think I could shave off a minute or two if I get to use one of these, though they might consider that cheating. We'll have to check on the rules for that. Overall, the experience was similar to most AIOs, but without fussing too much with the brackets, if you're using AMD. The pump has a couple of cables that plug into it, one for USB and one braided cable bundled for SATA power, fan RGB, and the motherboard pump header all connected. This braided cable is a bit on the chunkier side, so you might want to think about how you want to mount it. The GA2 LCD also has 45 degree rotary fittings for its hoses on the radiator, which can be incredibly helpful when you're positioning hoses inside your build for those epic glamour shots. These hoses are a bit shorter than other AIOs we've built with, so that's something to think about when you're positioning the GA2 LCD's pump head and where you're gonna put it in your build. So getting a bit more into the specs here, the GA2 LCD has an Robeytech 8th gen water pump at its heart. The pump has a three-phase motor with speeds up to 3600 RPM, an optimized internal design to increase the contact surface area for newer AMD and Intel processors, and better fluid pathways to improve circulation. As for the fans, we're actually pretty big fans of them, especially when you see the numbers we're about to show you. These ARGB fans have a max speed of 2450 RPM and a CFM rating of 79.9. In other words, they can move air really fast. That does mean the fans are going to be a bit more noticeable when running at full speeds. It's around 30 decibels, so that's about the volume of a normal conversation. In other words, they're gonna be noticeable, but it's not gonna be like gaming laptop loud. I mean, seriously, I think they just put jet engines in though. I mean, it's literally like that. Now, when it comes to the centerpiece of this AIO, the LCD display, it's probably one of the nicer LCDs that we've seen on an AIO when it comes to color reproductions. Blues look like blues, green looks like green, and the reds taste like strawberries. And it's square, which, you know what, Kevin really liked. When it comes to colors, control, and customization options, the GA2 LCD relies on the help of Lian Li's L-Connect 3 software. With L-Connect, you can control the pump and fan profiles, as well as do all the fun stuff with the LCD. You can use it to display a clock face or system information in real time, while layering in a number of background effects, like fireworks and weather effects like rain or snow, in case you live someplace like you need to be reminded what snow looks like Hawaii. Or you can customize the LCD with your favorite cat memes and GIFs or MP4 videos of Robey Cat. Yes. The images are pretty crisp, though we wouldn't say the display on the GA2 LCD is more or less bright than its peers. I'm sorry if anyone has ever described you that way. I'm just saying, you're not that bright. Okay, let's look at the performance. At CPU idle, the GA2 LCD matched Corsair's H150i Elite, H150i Elite Capellix, and one of Lian Li's other Galahad 2 AIOs, the GA2 Trinity SL. With average temperature sitting at 36 degrees Celsius, in our charts, these coolers were sitting 1 degree Celsius below the hottest running AIO in the category, Corsair's H150i Elite LCD XT. For perspective, our record for the coolest temperature is the Asus Ryujin 3 at 33 degrees Celsius. Now, in our CPU load test, we crank things up to 100% in Cinebench, and Lian Li's GA2 LCD understood the assignment. Averaging temperatures of 81 degrees Celsius, the GA2 LCD bested the reigning king of cold in this AIO benchmark, the Fantex Glacier 1T30, which is impressive. For some perspective, the nearest LCD-equipped AIO was the Ryujin 3, which fell behind the GA2 by 2 degrees Celsius. During our gaming test, we had a bit of a leapfrog situation here. The GA2 LCD did hold its colder temperatures, but the Ryujin 3 hopped over it by 1 degree Celsius. Considering that the GA2 LCD bested NZXT's Kraken by 1C, and also Corsair's H150 Elite LCD XT by 4 degrees Celsius, the GA2 LCD was nothing short of impressive. Now that we've seen how it's performed, let's look at relative value of the GA2 LCD. In case you slept during our last couple cooler reviews, here's the fancy math. Its CPU thermal max, which is 100 degrees Celsius in this case, minus the CPU temperature under load. Then we divide the number by the retail price. That gives us a relative, it's like dollars per degree of cooling value when we then sort and compare it. Now here's the deal, guys. This is not considering all the other functions, it's literally just money and value. Now this has a score of 14.73. Lian Li's value proposition lands in the middle of the pack, in 7th place to be exact. It trailed ever so slightly behind Corsair's H150i Elite Capellix at 14.66 and the Fantex Glacier 1T30 at 14.44. When we look at just AIOs with LCDs, the story changes drastically. The H150i Elite XT from Corsair scored 17.85, the Asus Ryujin Nugen 3 scored 20.58, and the NZXT Kraken Elite scored 26.9999999999. So in this grouping, the Galahad 2 is the value leader, a gentleman and a scholar, if you will, among its peers. Good job, buddy. Way to go. So with all of that in mind, with all the information we pumped into your brain, what did you think about the GA2 LCD? Lean in close, because you aren't gonna wanna miss this. I really like it. Everything about this AiO feels high quality, from the materials used and the beautiful screen and the thoughtful additions, like rubber rings to hold the brackets in place. It seems like Lian Li thought about just about everything. And honestly, after spending a bunch of time with their CEO, the dude really loves coming up with really great solutions for PC cooling and PC cases. And my favorite part, it came with a thermal paste spreader. I mean, come on. Seriously, not a lot of manufacturers think of things like that, but it's such a nice touch when they do. Now, the installation process was made super easy thanks to Lian Li's SL Infinity fans, the new mounting for 8th gen Asetek pumps, and the angled tubing. The one word of caution that I'll give, and it's not really a word of caution, but more of a situational awareness thing, is that some users have reported issues with L-Connect software not recognizing their LCD. Lian Li is totally aware of the issue, and they chalk it up to USB cables not being plugged into the LCD properly, but you know what, check your cables, and honestly, they have great customer support, so if you continue to have issues, make sure you reach out. That consideration aside, we don't really have any other negative words to say about it. We just really wish we knew where those performance fans went. It's just, seriously, just disappeared. Now, those were our thoughts on the Galahad 2 LCD from Lian Li, but we wanna know what you think down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring the notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post videos like this right here at Robeytech. Anyway, and if you want to talk more about cooling or cooling options or what the best cooler might be for your CPU, head over to discord.gg/Robeytech. It's a great place to talk to like-minded tech enthusiasts who'd love to share their opinion. And you know what? You might make a friend. Also, you can follow at Robeytech absolutely everywhere, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.